I looked up the dictionary and I couldn't find words like nyash, ogo, yam leg. And these are slangs and words we often use in our daily conversations. Do you even know that there are better ways for you to say handpits, hunchback, bow leg in your conversations? Well, stay around and watch this video to the end. It's going to explain how to replace these words or these slangs in your discussions and sound intellect.
Hi, meet Jemima Chukwu, a groundbreaker, leader, professional, and researcher who is perfervid about positively influencing, impacting, and inspiring people. I welcome you to my YouTube channel. It promises to share insightful content on health, leadership, education, networking, and tourism.
So the first slang is yam leg. This one, you even hear different culture in Nigeria referring to yam leg as either ngbaji or yeah. Please, if you know what they call yam leg in your culture, please drop it down on the comment section. So yam leg, that part of the leg is where the gastrocnemius muscle is located. Gastrocnemius muscle. In a sentence, I'm going to kick your gastrocnemius muscle with anger. Her very large gastrocnemius muscle disfigured her body. Hey, see gastrocnemius muscle. See yam leg. Gastrocnemius muscles. Next, handpits. If you say handpits, you agree to go. But to be more anatomical, you can replace handpits with axilla. Not to bore you with so much anatomy, axilla is the pyramidal space beneath the glenohumeral joint. This space, like. In a sentence, she fractured her hand and can't extend her axilla. Or, her axilla region is smelling, like the smell from her axilla is so offensive. Axilla. Remember, axilla. Sound more anatomical, formal, and intellect. So if you've not subscribed to my YouTube channel, please hit the subscribe button now. Please hit it. The next word is ogo. So you often hear people say, that guy has a big ogo. That place you call ogo is anatomically called occiput. This place you call ogo is occiput. Now, occiput is the back of the head formed by the occipital bone. And still in that region, this other ogo you call like front ogo, back ogo. The back ogo is occiput, while the front is sinciput. So sinciput is formed by the frontal bone, while the occiput is formed by the occipital bone. So in a sentence, you say, that guy's occiput is so prominent. Compared to Harry's, his sinciput is so big. And you're good to go. Occiput, sinciput. So the next word is nyash. Hey, nyash is so casual, informal. If you want to sound formal, you can say glitters. So the glital region, that's the nyash, which you call, the glital region is formed by three glutei muscles and the tensor fasciae latae. In a sentence, I feel pain in my glutei region. Is my glutes shaking or is my glutes muscle shaking? Squatting could increase your glutes muscles. So this is how to sound official when saying, instead of saying yash, you use glutes and you're good to go. So before I expose the next word, I would like to thank the sponsors of this video, Jemima's Think Tank Initiative. So this initiative is a platform where experts guide youths on matters concerning health, their career, education, and writing seminars, research, how to do well in their academic work. So if you have loved ones that could benefit from this, quickly send an email to Jemima's Think Tank Initiative and you have experts to handle the situation. I wonder why people refer to this particular muscle as muscle. Especially children, you see when they want to fight, like in a tug of war, they'll be like, bring your muscle, let's challenge. Well, that place you just refer to as just muscle is specifically called bicep. Bicep, tricep. Biceps, triceps. He visits the gym regularly, and that's why his biceps is so obvious. Look at my biceps. Now, hunchback. Hunchback is okay, but to be more anatomical, you could replace it with kyphosis. So kyphosis is a condition in which the spine in the upper back has an excessive curvature. Now, using it in a sentence, you could say, "Thank God I don't have kyphosis. I wish I hadn't kyphosis." Kyphosis make that girl look awkward. The seventh and the last word is boleg. If you say boleg, you're good to go. But to be more anatomical and to sound intellect, you could say genuvarum. Genuvarum. Genuvarum is an abnormality or deformity where the legs curve outwards at the knee, as you can see in the picture. So using it in a sentence, you can say, "Genuvarum is not a thing to be boastful of. It's not good. I feel pain there." Then you could also use genuvalum. Genuvalum. Genuvalum is when you're talking about not knee, that's K leg, you get. So genuvarum, genuvalum. Genuvarum, genuvalum. Bow legs, not knee. Now we've come to the end of this video. If this video was helpful, please give this video a thumbs up, like the video, and subscribe to my YouTube channel. Also share to your friends so they could benefit from this educational talk. Bye bye.